Hello friends, so today in this session we will study work done in adiabatic process. So under this process we will study two processes, one is reversible, second is the irreversible process. So we will find out the work done in both the process, reversible and irreversible. So first is reversible. So during adiabatic expansion or compression, heat is neither absorbed or not evolved by the system. So what does this mean? This means that the heat is equal to zero. That is the small change of heat, whatever small change is, that is zero. Every infinitesimal change of pressure is in this case heat will be zero. So by first law we know that is the delta U is equal to Q plus W, and if Q is equal to zero, then definitely the delta U is equal to W. That is, or you can say small changes. If you take small change in internal energy, then there will be small change of W. So we can say that work is done by the system under adiabatic process on account of its internal energy. Means all the work is done due to the internal energy. Similarly, we can say work done by the surrounding on the system is under adiabatic process, and it gives rise to an equivalent increase in internal energy of the system. So let's take, if work is expansion only, then we can say delta V is the small increase in volume, then P is the pressure of the gas, and then dW is equal to minus P delta V, and delta U is equal to P delta V. So this is the relationship. And for ideal gas CV, that is the heat capacity at constant volume, will be equal to du by dt, or du is equal to cv into dt, that we have seen it. So cv dt is equal to p into dv. So delta h will is equal to what? U plus p delta v. Delta h is equal to delta, this is h is nothing but u plus p delta v. So we can write delta u plus p delta v, or delta p into v, or delta p into v is nothing but the pv is equal to rt. We can write this equation or this equation, or we can write delta u is equal to r delta t if small temperature is taking place inside the adiabatic system. So uv is cv delta t, and this is r delta t. So r delta t taking out common, this becomes your r plus cv, or r plus cv is nothing but the cp into t2 minus t1. So we got one relationship, that is the change in enthalpy is nothing but cp into change in temperature. So for any type of adiabatic process, reversible or irreversible, q will be always zero, and w is equal to delta u, and delta u is cv delta p, and delta h is cp delta t. Now here two cases arises. So during the adiabatic process, if you know the final temperature, if you know the final temperature, initial temperature we know that is T, but after the this one adiabatic process, suppose you know the final temperature, then internal energy is a function of volume and temperature. So we can write this is on differentiation of this, so du by with respect to V with respect to T. So du by dt, so delta U by delta T at constant volume will be dt, plus du by delta U by delta V at constant temperature into dV. And for partial, this ideal gas, du by dV at constant temperature is zero, because at constant temperature internal energy become constant, so this will be zero. So if this is zero, means what? This becomes your zero. So du is directly depending upon this one, that is this one. So we can write du is equal to nCV into dT. For a finite change, this change in internal energy is nCV, that is T2 minus T1. So we can write reversible work is nothing but the du, and this is equal to nCV into T2 minus T1. So this is one equation. Now Cp minus Cv equal to what? This is the Mayer relations. So dividing by Cv, you will get this relation, or Cv is equal to R upon gamma minus 1. So this is the gamma minus 1. So we can say Cv this side, R by gamma minus 1. So reversible work is change in energy into nCv into T2 minus T1, and instead of Cv, we can write here R equal to gamma minus 1. So this is one more relationship, and the value of gamma is always 1 depending on the type of gases, monatomic, diatomic and polyatomic, so that we have already seen it. Now if we decide if T2 is greater than T1, then definitely the work is equal to is positive, and that is work is done on the system. And if T2 is lesser than T1, this temperature is lesser than T1, definitely work will be your reversible work will be your negative, because this is a negative quantity. So this negative quantity means work is done by the system. So all these are mathematical, it is coming mathematically, these values are coming mathematically. Now these two points keep in mind, the above equation A and B, A and B means this is one equation A, this is one equation B. So these are applicable to any type of adiabatic process, whether reversible, irreversible or free expansion. However, fire temperature will be different in each case. So work done, delta U and delta H will be different if temperature is different. Then if the fire temperature is known, the value of Q, W, delta U and delta H for any type of adiabatic process can be calculated by the above equation A and B. Now we'll see, if you don't know the fire temperature, then what will happen? The work done is equal to, we are taking the small amount of work, so integrate this all work. So this is for small amount of work, each work is P external pressure into dV. So for a small amount of work, there is a small expansion take place and multiplying with the external pressure. So just integrate it. So we'll get here pressure of the gas into dV. So on multiplying, this is our equation. And what is the pressure of the gas? So since this is a small pressure, so we can write P external pressure is nothing but the pressure of gas plus or minus dP. What is pressure of gas? Pressure of gas is the pressure of the gas for reversible process. And again, this pressure of gas is the function of volume and temperature. So here both volume and temperature is changing during adiabatic expansion or compression process. So if fire temperature is not known, then for adiabatic process we have dU is equal to dW. So right here dU is nothing but the CV dT, and dW is minus P external dV. So for ideal gases, we know that is the PV equal to nRT, and this P external is nRT by V. So just substitute this value. This is CV dT, and substituting the P external by nRT by V, so we'll get minus changing the limits of the temperature also. So in this case, T1 to T2. In this case, if you're taking the dV, it will be V1 to V2. So here we are changing the limits of the volume, in this case temperature. So this will becomes your nRT by V, and this is your CV dT. So taking T this side, so CV dT by T, limit from T1 to T2, and in this case is minus R dV by V, limit V1 to V2. So this will become so CV natural log T2 by T1, and this is minus R natural log V1 P2 by V1. So CV natural log T2 by T1 from this equation. So this R natural log V2 by V1. So from this we can say CV natural log T2 by T1, and this will become your R is nothing but we can say CP minus CV. So if you divide by CV, so you will get natural log T2 by T1 equal to minus R for CV natural log V2 by V1. And R by CV is nothing but the 1 minus gamma from this is coming. Or we can write natural log T2 by T1 is equal to 1 minus gamma into natural log V2 by V1. Or taking T2 by T1, so if you take the square, this one, removing the natural log, this will go to the power. This can be also derived from this side also. So this is natural log T2 by T1 into CV, natural log V2 by V1 into minus R. So if you solve it, you will get T2 minus T1 upon V2 by V1 into 1 minus gamma. So it becomes same equation. Either by two process, we can take T1, that is the T2 V2. So if you take T2 V2, so this 1 minus gamma will be reversed, it becomes your gamma minus 1. We can see it. So these equations are very careful. So this becomes your TV gamma minus 1 equal to constant. So we got one relationship from this derivation when temperature is not known. Now if you use the pressure, volume is proportional to temperature, so pressure will be proportional to T by V. Now T by T2 by T1, so in this case V2 by V1, so putting the value V2 by V1 by P1 T2 by P2 T1 into 1 minus gamma. So this V2 by V1 means from here it is coming. So you can see here, so we can write here like this one. So P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. Okay, so if you take the V2 by V1, so definitely what will happen? So V1 this side, so definitely you will get P1 by T2 divided by P2 into T1. So we are putting this value over here, the 1 minus gamma. So T2 by T1, this is the 1 minus gamma. So if you shift this whole value this side, it becomes your gamma minus 1. So P2 by P1 equal to gamma minus 1. So T2 by T1 is gamma minus 1 plus 1. So this becomes your gamma, and this is P2 by P1 equal to gamma. So we can write P2 by P1. Into gamma equal to P2 by P1 into gamma minus 1, or P1 by P2 into gamma 1 minus gamma. Okay, so T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 into gamma minus 1 by gamma, if you take the square root of gamma. So this is nothing but the, if you see carefully, this is the P2 T2, or it becomes your T1. So this becomes your P1 T1 P2 T2. So if you take the reverse case, it becomes your 1 minus gamma. From here, we have 1 minus gamma. So T1 gamma P1 1 minus gamma, this is equal to T2 gamma P2 1 minus gamma. So we can take constant as a T gamma P into 1 minus gamma equal to constant. So overall we can write T gamma and P to the power 1 minus gamma is equal to constant, or TP 1 minus gamma divided by gamma is equal to constant. So all these nothing but the same value, and each value is rearranging. Then what is the relationship between pressure and volume? We have seen it, TP gamma and TV gamma. Now we have to find the PV gamma. So T2 by T1 is there, and V2 by V1 is 1 minus gamma. This we already derived. Now T2 by T1 is equal to, this is the coming from the Boyle's law. So this can be written as the P2 by P1 into gamma minus 1 by 2. This is the one equation, this is the second equation. Okay, so this we can relate each other. So this becomes your this becomes your, just equating this one. Now if you take the square root of this one, 1 minus gamma, so this becomes your 1 minus gamma V2 by V1 is 1 minus gamma. So taking this one, you will get finally V2 by V1 is equal to P1 by P2 into 1 minus gamma. So we will get finally this equation. So raising the both sides to the power of gamma, so we will have P1 and P2 equal to V2 by V1 into gamma. So if you shift gamma this side, it becomes your gamma. So we can say P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 gamma. So we got this value PV gamma is equal to constant. Now we will see the expression for the work done in the adiabatic reversible expansion of an ideal gas. Now we will see the work done. So for adiabatic process, PV gamma is equal to constant, that we have already derived. So if you differentiate this equation, PV gamma, so we will get P into gamma into V to the power gamma S1 into dB plus V into gamma dP by plus. So we are differentiating. So taking this constant value outside, okay, this one, so rearranging, you will get gamma, this is the same value. And if you divide this whole value by V to the power gamma S1, so on dividing, you will get gamma P into dot dp plus vdp equal to 0. So vdp is equal to gamma p into pdv, and for ideal gas pv is equal to nrt. So if you differentiate this equation also, you will get pv pdv plus vdp nrdt. Okay, now substituting the vdp in 1 here, so this is the vdp in 1. So if you substitute this value in 1, so what will happen? So you will get the pdv equal to, so this whole value will be over here. So PdV plus gamma into P into dP into nRT. So substitute this value VdP, this value over here. If you substitute this value this side, so you will get this equation. So from, if you are solving, so taking the 1 minus gamma dV common, PdV common, so you will get 1 minus gamma equal to nRDT. So PdV equal to nRDT by 1 minus gamma. So this is the equation which is actually we are getting. So it's PdV. Now for adiabatic process, process work done in reversible process is external PD, external P pressure into dV, taking the limit V1 to V2. So now you substitute this PdV over here. So whole value over here. So changing the limit of from volume to temperature. So initially the limit was volume, now change to temperature. So this becomes of nRdT divided by 1 minus R. So this is the constant. So delta T is there. So this is your nothing but the T2 minus T1. So reversible work done during reversible process, adiabatic reversible process, will be your nR 1 minus gamma equal to T2 minus T1. This is, we have another value. Expression for work done may be obtained in different forms. So we will see the different forms. So reversible work done, that we have derived nR divided by 1 minus gamma equal to T2 minus T1, or we can say nR into 1 gamma minus 1 into T1 minus T2. Anyone, we can use it. So it is not, if you are taking minus 1 this side, so this will be your like this. Okay, so nR 1 minus gamma equal to this T2 is nothing but the P2 V2 by nR, and this T1 is NP1 V1 by nR. So you can substitute this value. On substituting, this nR will be cancelled, so we will get reversible process will be P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1. So now using lesson, T1 gamma P1 1 minus gamma equal to T2 gamma P2 1 minus gamma. So T2 gamma is nothing but the T1 gamma P1 1 minus gamma, this will be your P2 into 1 minus gamma. So T1 gamma is constant outside, so this will be P1 and P2 into 1 minus gamma. So if you take the square root of this one with by gamma, so you will get T2 by equal to T1 into P1 by P2 into 1 minus gamma by gamma. So T1 is P1 by P2, and 1 minus gamma by gamma is nothing but the 1 minus CP by CP or CP by CP. So if you solve it, you will get this value. So T1 into P1 by P2 to the power minus R upon Cp. Now from equation 1. So which is equation 1? Equation 1 is this one. Nr into 1 minus gamma equal to T2 minus T1. So you have substituted the value of T. So if you substitute the value of T2, so you will get here Nr 1 minus gamma is equal to, this will be your T2 minus, this is your T1, so T1 minus T1 into P1 by P2 into minus R upon Cp. And if you take the T1 outside, so Nr T1 1 minus gamma, so this become 1 minus P2 by P1 into R upon Cp. So this is there. This is P1 by P2, so if you take the minus, it becomes P2 by P1. So reversal process will be Nr Cb T1 1 minus P2 over P1 R by Cp. And since Cb is equal to R upon 1 minus gamma, so we can write like this one. So similarly, this is the, in this case we can see final temperature is not given. So we can get the this another work. Now if you know that two process, two P1, P2 and one only T1, we can still find the work done during reversible process. Similarly, we can find the relation between T1, V1 and V2 can be derived like this one by using the different laws of T1, P1, V1, gamma like the TB relationship, like the PT relationships. So using the equation 2 above. So equation 2, we know that this is the equation 2. Let us see. Reversal work done is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1. So by this relationship already I have written here. So if you take the P2 V2 outside, this become your common 1 minus P1 V1 by P2 V2. So this becomes your P1 and P2 is equal to P2 by P1 into 1 minus gamma. How? P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 in the gamma. So if you substitute the V1 by V2 equal to P2 by V1, so you will get this relationship. So this will convert into P2 by P1 into 1 minus gamma. Now, if you take, we can write P1 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma, P2 to the power 1 minus 1 minus gamma. So P2 V2 is equal to gamma minus 1 is multiplied by 1 minus P1 by P2 equal to gamma minus 1 by gamma. And P2 by P1, P2 V2 by gamma minus 1 equal to 1 minus P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is in terms of P1 by P2. In this temperature again absent, and this was equation, you can see here, you compare it this and with this equation, this and this equation almost both the same. So this is, in this cases P2 V2 is given, but in this cases your T1 is given. So question can be asked, if temperature is given, P1 P2 given, we will use this equation. If V2 is given, temperature absent, we will use this equation. So we can use any type of equations by using this. Only we have to remember two relationship. One is your reversible work, which Nr equal to Nr divided by 1 minus gamma into T2 minus T1. And one we have to remember, if temperature is not given, then P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1. And if third factor also comes, so by we can find out by using the derivations to get this type of results, this and this result. Relation between the isothermal process and adiabatic process. So what is the relation between these two process? So this is the graph. So we know that for isothermal, we can process, we draw the graph like this one. And for adiabatic, we draw the graph little bit down. So slope of this curve is more than this curve. That is theta of this curve is more than theta. So it's slope. How it is more than this one? Let us see that. For ideal gas, PV equal to constant, taking the log. So log P plus log B equal to log constant. So if you differentiate this with the help of B, so it becomes your 1 by P log log P by dB, and this will become your 1 by B equal to 0. Now multiply by dB. So you multiply by dB, so this becomes your dP by P, and this becomes your dV by B equal to 0. So now we can write dP by dV is equal to minus P upon B. So this becomes your slope of the this your ideal gas equation. Means isothermal curve. This is the slope of the isothermal curve. Now come to adiabatic condition. So in the adiabatic condition, if you take the PV gamma equal to constant, take the log, log P equal to gamma into log B equal to 0. And now if you differentiate with respect to V, that is volume, we will get 1 by P, that is dP by dP plus gamma by V equal to 0. So taking the above relationship, like similar, we will solve like a similar, dP by dV equal to gamma by V into P, or we can write minus gamma into P into V. So from this we can see, this is the slope of the adiabatic process. So we can write slope of the adiabatic process is nothing but the gamma times of the slope of isothermal. So definitely the this slope of adiabatic is more than the slope of the isothermal. So you can see from this curve graph, so this is the slope of the isothermal, and this if you are going below this one, this slope is more, this slope is more, this slope is more. So this side you can see, this is, suppose you are taking this slope, so this will make one angle, this will be your more steeper, this will be your more steeper, this is more steeper, it is coming to almost 90 degree. So it depends upon the gamma of the gas, if it is monatomic, diatomic or polyatomic. So you can see here it is again increasing order, so gamma. So whenever gamma is again increasing, the curve becomes more and more steeper, slope become more and more steeper or large. Now I have drawn here, it is a summary of all the process, that is the work done delta U, delta H in different type of adiabatic process. So these are the three processes: reversible, intermediate and free. Work done, final temperature, delta U and delta H. So for reversible process, work done will be NCB into change in temperature, work is negative for expansion. Temperature will be your T1 is greater than T2, du will be NCB T2 minus T1, U will be negative, delta H will be negative, CP into delta T2 minus T1. For intermediate process, again CB, temperature will say different, so T2 minus T1, condition will be same, again it will be same like the reversible process, everything will be same, delta U also negative, delta H also negative. For free expansion, so if free expansion, then work done is zero, this is the formula. Temperature becomes equal. Temperature becomes equal, internal energy also become equal, and enthalpy also become zero. Internal energy and enthalpy both become zero in free expansion, that we have already seen it. Now we see some solve problem. So in solve, because in an insulated container, if you take the 1 mole of ideal gas, is reversibly expanded to 600 Kelvin to 300 Kelvin. Calculate the work done by the gas if gas is monatomic, if gas is diatomic. So use the relationship, as the temperature is given, so we can use NR by gamma minus 1, T2 minus T1, this is the work done. For a monatomic, gamma is 1.6, substitute the value, you will get this answer. For diatomic, gamma is given 1.4, substitute the value, you will get this much answer. 0.4 mole of a monatomic gas, it fills in a 1 dm cube container to a pressure of this much pascal, and it is expanded reversibly and adiabatically until the pressure of this much pascal is reached. So calculate what is V2 of the gas, final volume of the gas in a container, and T1, T2, second is what is the initial temperature, what is the final temperature, and expansion work. So there are two pressures given, this is the initial pressure, this is the final pressure. Initial volume is given, we have to find the V2. So two pressure means we will use the formula P1 V1 gamma equal to P2 V2 gamma. So gamma we know that. So this is a monatomic gas, that is the gamma of the monatomic gas is 5.3. So from here we can find out V2. So V2 is equal to 3.98 dm cube. Now we have to find the temperature. So what is the initial temperature? So pressure is given, volume is given, and moles is also given, and R is given. So T1 will be your this much temperature, putting the value. And now use the second relationship T1 V1 gamma minus 1. So from this T1 we know that, V1 we know that, V2 we know that, gamma we know that. So we can find out T2. So T2 is equal to 121.28 Kelvin. Now we can find the work done, because we know that T2, we know that T1, and gamma we already know. So work done is equal to NR equal to gamma minus 1, T2 minus T1. So just substitute the value. On substituting, you will get the work done. Or if you don't want to use T2, so we have another relationship, P2 V2 minus P1 V1. If you don't know temperature, you can directly substitute this value also, and in this case again you will get the same answer. A sample of an argon gas at 1 atmospheric pressure and 27 degree centigrade expands reversibly and adiabatically from 1.25 dm cube to 2.5 dm cube. Calculate the enthalpy changes in this process. CVM of this argon gas is 12.48 joule per kelvin per mole is given. So delta H, we can say delta H is nothing but NCP into delta T. So what is CP? CP is CV plus R. So CV already given. So by adding 8.314 joule, because this is in joule, so we will take R value this much, so we will get 20.794 joule per kelvin. Now you know the relationship, T1 V1 gamma minus 1, T2 gamma into V2 gamma minus 1 is there. So in this case is T2 is not given, but T1, V1 and gamma is given. We can see here, this is the V1, V2, this is the T1 is given. Substitute the value in terms of Kelvin, you will get, and gamma is also given. On solving, you will get that T2 is 189.86 Kelvin. So change in temperature, how much? So T2 minus T1. So this is T2 minus T1, you will get the minus 110.714 Kelvin. Now delta H. Delta H is NCV into delta T. So delta T is given. What is N? So N will be your N equal to P by RT. So this is the P, this is the V, this is the R, this is the T. So it will come in terms of pressure. So this is the atmospheric pressure. N is given. That is 0.05 moles. This is your CV at joule Kelvin per mole. And this is your change in temperature. So you will get delta H is equal to, delta H is equal to minus 114.51 joule. So these are the answers.